family tree. Now, when you think of a family, you think of a mother, father, children, spouse, etc. But Jesus describes a true family. His true family as in Mark 3, 31, 34. Then Jesus' mother and brothers arrived. Standing outside, they sent someone in to call him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they told him, "Your mother and brothers are outside looking for you." Jesus replied, Who are my mother and my brothers?" he asked. Then he looked at those seated in a circle around him and said, Here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does God's will is my brother, my sister, my mother. So put him first as of our family tree. Who keeps us alive? We are the branches. His true children, those who do his will. As our true family, those who understand us as God, our Heavenly Father is God. And he gave his son, Jesus Christ, to become a human, who died and suffered, rose on the third day. For us and our sins, conquered death on the cross. So now we live for and through him. And he's our true purpose here. For Colossians 3:11-13, Apostle Paul, a true servant of Christ. Now, may our God and Father himself and our Lord Jesus clear the way for us to come to you. May the Lord make your love increase and overflow and flow for each other and everyone else, just as ours does for you as in brotherly love. May he strengthen your hearts, so that you will be blameless and holy. In the presence of our God and Father, our Lord Jesus Christ comes with all his saints, his holy ones. Matthew 10:32-33. Whoever acknowledges me before men, I will also acknowledge him before my Father in heaven. But whoever disowns me before men, I will disown him before my Father in heaven. So acknowledge him first before men, do his will. And we can live with him in our return home and live through eternity with his love, peace, joy, and his lies everywhere, and live throughout eternity. Amen. Amen. In his total peace.
Real bad all week. I mean, at least it hasn't been in the 90s to 100s with the humidity, if you know what I'm saying there. And the other place is in the sun. It's really cloudy today. I don't think it's supposed to rain. I don't know. It kind of looks like it though. And it's really humid today. Oh my goodness. Okay, now. Open ears and hear the real God's truth. First of all, I want to apologize for last week, okay? I was having camcorder problems and my song. I noticed you couldn't even hear the music in the background, so I'm going to redo it after my sermon. So, anyway, I apologize there. There's not too many places I can really go and preach. There is, I think, one major park not too far from here, but there's a lot of people in family unions, et cetera, and family picnics still. And it's kind of nice and peaceful over here. The other place is kind of in the sun, and there's not much of a breeze. There's a little bit of a breeze, so if the wind bothers my camcorder, I apologize. I tried to block it, but the highway's down there too, so excuse me there as well. I want to enjoy the outdoors as much as I can. So now, this week's sermon is called A Family Tree. Now when you think of a family, you think of a mother, father, children, spouse, etc. But Jesus describes his true family as in Mark 3:31-34. Then Jesus' mother and brothers arrived. Standing outside, they sent someone in to call him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they told him, "Your mother and brothers are outside looking for you." Jesus replied, Who are my mother and my brothers?" he asked. Then he looked at those seated in a circle around him and said, Here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does God's will is my brother, my sister, and my mother. So put him first as of our family tree, who keeps us alive. Amen, amen. We are the branches. His true children. Those who do His will. As our true family, those who understand us as God. Our Heavenly Father is God. And He gave His Son, Jesus Christ, to become a human, who died and suffered and rose on the third day, conquered death for us and our sins on the cross. So give your sins to the cross. Come on, everybody, give your sins to the cross. Pray to Him now. Come on. Let him die, and leave him there. Love, serve, and follow, and be faithful to God, our Heavenly Father, from this day forward. So now we live for and through Him. And our real true purpose here, He's our real true purpose here, towards eternal life with Him. 1 Corinthians 3, 11-13, Apostle Paul, a true servant of Christ, now may our God and Father Himself and our Lord Jesus clear the way for us to become to you, may the Lord make your love increase and overflow for each other, and everyone else, just as ours does for you, as in brotherly love, may he strengthen your hearts, so that you will be blameless and holy in the presence of our God and Father when our Lord Jesus comes with all His holy ones. Amen. The second coming of Christ Jesus. Matthew 10:32-33. Whoever acknowledges me before men, I will also acknowledge him before my Father in heaven. But whoever disowns me before men, I will disown him before my Father in heaven. So acknowledge him first before men. Do his will. Love, serve, and follow him. Be faithful to him. He is our God, our Heavenly Father. So we can live with him in our real eternal home. And live throughout eternity where there is love, peace, joy, and his light is everywhere. And we will live in his total peace with him. Amen. Okay, now let's pray. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive everyone who is indebted to us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Okay, well, he's given me a lot of Bible verses, so... And I didn't get that many done last week, but as long as you got the message. Okay, now, get your Bibles out. Joshua 1:9. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Amen. A lot of ants over here. Not too far from the airport too, so you can hear the airplane. Guiltless, His error inflicts an incurable wound. What man is like Job? What man is like Job? Who drinks scorn like water. He keeps company
with evildoers.
He associates with wicked men. For he says, it profits a man nothing when he tries to please God. So listen to me, you men of understanding. Far be it from God to do evil. From the Almighty to do wrong. He repays a man for what he has done. He brings upon him, what his conduct deserves. It is unthinkable that God would do wrong, that the Almighty would pervert justice. Who appoints him over the earth? Who put him in charge of the whole world? He's in charge of the whole world. If it were his intention and he withdrew his spirit and breath, all mankind would perish together. A man will return to the dust. If you have understanding, hear this. Listen to what I say. Can he who hates justice govern? Will you condemn the just and mighty one? Is he not the one who says to kings, you are worthless, and to nobles, you are wicked? Who shows no partiality to princes and does not favor the rich over the poor? For they are all the work of his hands. Amen. They die in an instant in the middle of the night. The people are shaken and they pass away. The mighty are removed without human hand. His eyes
are on the ways.
His eyes are on the ways of men. He sees their every step, There is no dark place, no deep shadow, where evildoers can hide. God has no need to examine men further, that they should come before him for judgment. Remember, we're going to be judged at the end between life and death, by and from whom what we truly love, serve, and follow. Here is our God. Without inquiry, he shatters the mighty, and sets up others in their place. Because he takes note of their deeds, he overthrows them in the night, and they are crushed. He punishes them for their wickedness. Where everyone can see them, because they turn from following him. They had no regard for any of his ways. They caused the cry of the poor to come before him, so that he heard the cry of the needy. But he remained silent. Who can condemn him? If he hides his face, who can see him? Yet he is over man and nation alike, to keep a godless man from ruling, from laying snares for the people. Suppose a man says to God, I am guilty but will offend no more. Teach me what I cannot see. If I have done wrong, I will not do so again. Should God then reward you on your terms? When you refuse to repent. Give your sins to the cross and I'm die. Love, serve, and follow our Heavenly Father. Be faithful to Him from this day forward. You must decide. Not I. So tell me what you know. Men of understanding, declare, wise men who hear me say to me. Job speaks without knowledge. His words lack insight. Oh, that Joe might be tested to the utmost for answering like a wicked, wicked man to his sin, he adds rebellion, rebellion, scornfully, scornfully. He claps his hands, among us and multiplies his words against God, Amen. Amen. Okay. Isaiah 2, the mountain of the Lord in the last days, the second coming. This is what Isaiah son of Amoz saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. In the last days, the mountain of the Lord's temple will be established as chief among the nations, among the mountains. It will be raised above the hills, and all nations will stream to it, Many people will come and say, come, come, let us go up the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. He will teach us his ways, so that we may walk, in his path, The law will go out from Zion, the words of the Lord from Jerusalem. He will judge, he will judge between the nations, and will settle dispute for many peoples. They will beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation will not take up sword against nation, nor will they train for war anymore. Come, O house of Jacob, let us walk in the light of the Lord, the day of the Lord. You have abandoned your people, the house of Jacob. You are full of superstitions from the east. They practice divination like the Philistines and clasp hands with pagans, Remember, we stayed on pagans a couple weeks ago. Their land is full of silver and gold, money. There is no end. There is no end to their treasures. Excuse me, I got a bug in here. Their land is full of horses. There is no end to their chariots. Their land is full of idols. They bow down.
WCIC.
To work of their hands,
And here's for King and Country.
To what their fingers have made, So man will be brought low and mankind humbled. Do not forgive them. Go unto the rocks, hide in the ground from the dread of the Lord and the splendor of his majesty. The eyes of the arrogant, man will be humbled, and the pride of man brought low. The Lord alone will be exalted in that day. The Lord Almighty has a day in store for all the proud and lofty, for all that is exalted, and they will be humbled. For all the cedars of Lebanon, tall and lofty, and all the oaks of Bashan, for all the towering mountains and all the high hills, for every lofty tower and every fortified wall, for every trading ship and every stately vessel, the arrogance of man, will be brought low, and the pride of men humbled. The Lord alone will be exalted in the day, and the idols, will totally disappear. Men will flee to caves and rocks. And to holes in the ground, from the dread of the Lord and the splendor of his majesty. When he rises to shake the earth, he's going to shake the earth. In that day, men will throw away to the rodents and bats their idols, of silver and idols of gold, which is money, etc. Whatever you bow down to, love, serve, and follow, you should go. Whatever, whoever it is, which they made to worship, they will flee to caverns in the rocks. They will flee to caverns in the rocks and to the overhanging crags. From dread of the Lord and the splendor of his majesty, when he rises to shake the earth. Stop trusting in man. Stop trusting in man. Who has but a breath? But a breath and it's a nostril. Of what account is he? Amen. Amen. Okay.
I got a bug bite.
Okay. Excuse me. Okay. Like I said, I have a lot of... Excuse me. I got bugs here. Prophet Hananiah, Jeremiah 28, we studied that a couple weeks ago. Okay, oh, the highway is loud. Like I said, there's not too many places I can actually go, so excuse me. Matthew 3, 10. The axe is already at the root of the trees, and every tree that does not produce good fruit, will be cut down and thrown into the fire, which is hell. Amen, amen. One who is more powerful than I, whose sandals I am not fit to carry, he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit, and with fire. The Holy Spirit and with fire. His winnowing fork in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor, gathering his wheat into the barn and burning up the chaff, which is the husk. Corn
for
and grass
and with shoulders,
with unquenchable fire. Unquenchable fire. John baptizes Jesus. When Jesus came from Galilee to the Jordan to be baptized by John, but John tried to deter him, saying, I need to be baptized by you. Do you come to me? Jesus replied, let it be so now. It is proper for us to do this to fulfill all righteousness. Then John consented. As soon as Jesus was baptized, he went up out of the water. At that moment, heaven was open, and he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lightning on him. And a voice from heaven said, this is my Son, whom I love. This is my Son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Amen, amen.
You're facing something challenging. If you feel like
okay.
Crashing in on you,
there's not much of a breeze.
You can use it to shape and mold you and draw you closer to him.
Thanks to
Kidder
Music and
WCIC. Matthew 12:46. Jesus describes his true family. While Jesus was still talking to the crowd, his mother and brother stood outside wanting to speak to him. Someone told him, your mother and brothers are standing outside waiting to speak to you. He replied to them, Who is my mother and who is my brothers? Pointing to his disciples, he said, here are my mother and my brothers. For whoever does the will of my Father who is in heaven, is my brother and sister and mother. Amen, amen. Matthew 15. Go to Matthew 15, excuse me. My throat's dry. Then some Pharisees and teachers of the law came to Jesus from Jerusalem. Excuse me, I got another book. And asked, Why do your disciples break the tradition of the elders? Why don't they wash their hands before they eat? Jesus replied, and why do you break the command of God for the sake of your tradition? Your tradition. For God said, honor your mother and your father. And anyone who curses his mother or father must be put to death. But you say that if a man says to his mother and father, whatever help you might otherwise have received from me is a gift devoted to God, he is not to honor his father with it. Trust you, nullify the word of God for the sake of your tradition. You hypocrites, you hypocrites. Isaiah was right when he prophesied about you. These people honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me, are far from me. They worship me in vain. Their teaching are but rules, taught by men. Jesus called the crowd to him and said, listen and understand, listen and understand. What goes in a man's mouth does not make him unclean. What comes out of his mouth, that is what makes him unclean. Then disciples came to him and asked, do you know that the Pharisees were offended when they heard this? He replied, every plant that my heavenly father has not planted, will be pulled up by the roots. Leave them. They are blind guides. If a blind man leaves a blind man, both will fall into the pit. Both will fall into the pit, which is hell. Peter said, explain the parable to us. Are you still so dull? Jesus asked them, don't you see that whatever enters the mouth goes into the stomach and then out of the body? But the things that comes out of the mouth come from the heart, and these make a man unclean. For out of the heart comes evil thoughts, murder, adultery, sexual morality, theft, false testimony, slander, excuse me. These are what makes a man unclean. But eating and washing hands does not make him unclean. Amen. Okay, excuse me. Like I said, I might not get them all done this week. He's giving me a lot of Bible verses, and I didn't get them all done last week, so. Praising God, but okay, Mark 3:31. Jesus describes his true family. Then Jesus' mother and brothers arrived standing outside. They sent someone in to call to him. A crowd was sitting around him, and they told him, your mother and brothers are outside looking for you. Who are my mother and my brothers? He asked. Then he looked at those sitting in a circle around him and said, here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does God's will is my brother, my sister, and my mother. Amen. Love and teach you people about the Bible being judged, mocked, well, ridiculed, laughed at. In Jesus Christ's case, they mocked him, spit on him, flogged him, and killed him, all by and from the strong faith in God, our Heavenly Father. Amen, amen. Somebody to save, Mark 12:29, the most important commandment is, said Jesus, it is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is to love your neighbor as yourself. There is no commandment greater than these. Love your neighbor as yourself, as in brotherly love. As in Exodus 20, it says 10 commandments. John 1:10, he was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him, which is Jesus Christ. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, Children born not of natural descendant, nor of human decision or husband's will, but born of God. Amen. I'm gonna read 14 till I get to. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. This is Jesus Christ. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father who is in heaven, full of grace and truth. Verse 15, John the Baptist testified concerning him, Jesus Christ. He cries out, saying, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me has surpassed me, because he was before me.' From the fullness of his grace, we will all receive one blessing after another, for the law was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Christ Jesus, No one has ever seen God, but God, the one and only, who is at the Father's side, has made him known." Amen, amen. Looks like it's gonna rain. Starting to pout up. John 3:19, this is the verdict: light is coming to the world, but men love darkness instead of light, because their deeds were evil. Everyone who does evil hates the light and will not come into the light, for fear of his deeds will be exposed. But whoever lives by the truth comes into the light, so that it may be seen plainly that what he has done is written to God. Amen, amen. I mean, I hope it doesn't rain. I don't remember him saying anything about rain. So better make this fast. Looks like rain. Smells like rain too. Kinda. Oh, you know what I'm saying? Just for a rain's kind of got that certain odor in the air. I don't know how to explain it. Anyway. Religious leaders surround Jesus at the temple. John 10:22. Then came the feast of dedication at Jerusalem. It was winter, and Jesus was in the temple area walking in Solomon's command. Jews gathered around him, saying, "How long will you keep us in suspense? If you are the Christ, tell us plainly." Jesus answered, "I did tell you, but you do not believe. The miracles I do in my Father's name, speak for me. But you do not believe because you are not my sheep." My sheep listen to my voice, to my voice. I know them. I know them. And they follow me. I give them eternal life. I give them eternal life. And they shall never perish. They shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand. My Father who is in heaven has given them to me. Is greater than all. No one can snatch them out of my Father in heaven's hand. I and the Father are one. Jesus speaking. Again, the Jews picked up stones to stone him, but Jesus said to them, I have shown you many great miracles from the Father in heaven. Which of these do you stone me? We are not stoning you for any of these, replied the Jews, but the blasphemy, because you are a mere man claiming to be God. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law, I have said you are gods? If he called them gods to whom the word of God came, and the scripture cannot be broken, the scripture cannot be broken. What about the one whom the Father in heaven set apart as his very own and sent into the world? Why then do you accuse me of blasphemy because I said I am God's son? Do not believe me unless I do what my Father does. My Father does. It's Jesus speaking. But I do it even though you do not believe me. Believe the miracles that you may know and understand that the Father in heaven is in me, and I in the Father. Again, they tried to seize him, but he escaped their grasp. When Jesus went back across the Jordan to the place where John had been baptized in the early days, here he stayed, and many people came to him. They said, though John never performed a miraculous sign, all that John said about this man was true. And in that place, many believed in Jesus. Amen, amen. It's really clouding up. Excuse me. Okay, I'm about to make this bad. The weather looks like rain. Trying to trick you. on the crayon chair, we speak as men approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel. We are not trying to please man. We are not trying to please man, but God who tests our heart. You know, we will never use flattery, nor did we put on a mask to cover up greed. God is our witness. We were not looking for praise from men, not from you or anyone else. As apostles of Christ, we could have been a burden to you, but we were gentle among you, like a mother caring for her little children. We loved you so much that we were, delighted to share with you not only the gospel of God, but our lives as well, because you had become so dear to us. Surely you remember, brothers, our toil and hardship. We work night and day in order not to be a burden to anyone while we preach the gospel of God to you. You are witnesses, and so is God, of how holy, righteousness, and blameless we were among you who believe. For you know that we dealt with each of you as a father deals with his own children, encouraging, comforting, and urging you to live lives worthy of God, who calls you into. Also thank God that contentment, because when you receive the word of God, which you heard from us, you accepted it not as the word of man, as it actually is. The word of God, which is at work in you, is at work in you who believe. For you, brothers, became imitators of God's church in Judea, which are in Christ Jesus. You suffered from your own countrymen the same things those churches suffered from the Jews, who killed the Lord Jesus and the prophets, and also drove us out. They displeased God and are hostile to all men. In their effort to keep us from speaking to the Gentiles so that they may be saved, in this way they always heap up their sins to the limit. The wrath of God has come upon them at last. Brothers, when we were torn away from you for a short time, in person, not in thought, out of our intense longing, we made every effort to see you. But we wanted to come to you, certainly I, Paul, did again and again, but Satan stopped us. For what is our hope, our joy, or the crown in which we will glory? In the presence of our Lord Jesus. The Lord Jesus, when he comes, it is not you. Indeed, you are our glory and joy. Okay, let's go to 1 Corinthians 4. Finally, brothers, we instruct you how to live in order to please God. As in fact, you are living. Now we ask you and urge you in the Lord Jesus to do this more and more. For you know what instructions we gave you by the authority of the Lord Jesus. It is God's will, that you should be sanctified, dedicated to God, that you should avoid sexual morality, that each of you should learn to control his own body, in a way that is holy and honorable, not in passionate lust, like the heathen. who do not know God. And that in this matter, no one should wrong his brother or take advantage of him. And that in this matter, no one should wrong his brother or take advantage of him. Take advantage of him. The Lord will punish men for all such sins. As we have already told you and warned you, for God did not call us to be impure, but to live a holy life, a holy life. Therefore, he who rejects this instruction does not reject man, does not reject man, but God, who gives you his Holy Spirit, his Holy Spirit. Now about brotherly love, we do not need to write to you, for you yourselves have been taught by God to love each other. And in fact, you do love all the brothers throughout Macedonia. Yeah, we urge you, brothers, to do so more and more. Make it your ambition, to lead a quiet life, to mind your own business, and to work with your hands, just as we told you, so that your daily life may win the respect of outsiders, so that you will not be dependent on anybody. Coming of the Lord. Brother, we do not want you to be ignorant about those who fall asleep or to grieve like the rest of men who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, so that we believe that God will bring Jesus, those who have fallen asleep in him, according to the Lord, to the Lord's own word. We tell you that we who are still alive, who are left till the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with a voice, of the archangel, and the trumpet call of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. After that, we who are still alive, and are left, we'll be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord, in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage each other with this, with these words, Amen, There's a lot going on out here too. There's a lot of people everywhere. It's really clouding up, so. Okay, number one, love, serve, and follow our Heavenly Father. Be faithful to him. Number two, love and take care of your personal family, your spouse, and children. Number three comes work 40, 50 hours a week. Number four comes friends. My number one purpose for my organization is to preach the gospel, the real God's truth. Number two is to help people. And number three is to help clean up our major cities and make them a better, safer place to live. I've been by the government, Bruce Warner, on some issues, and helped me with some funding. He's emailed me back, the councilman on some issues, and Mayor Jim Artis, and to put up the fence completely around the playground, on the riverfront by the Riverplex, where two young children have drowned in the past few years for their safety. That's my main issue right now. I'm slowly working on the path of my neighborhood for walkers and joggers. I finished the sign. It needs a lot of work, the path does. There's piles and piles of wood on it, etc. So it'll take time and patience, so excuse me there. I've seen a truck there a few days ago. Maybe the councilman's doing something, but still, I'll keep you informed there and keep working on it. I'm going to college to be the military filling substitute pastor and counselor. My PayPal for donations on my site is getting set up, finally. on my organization's bank account. So if you want to donate, keep watching my site. My oldest son's taking on a second job, so but he is getting it done this week. So he's busy, and he does my site for me. I finished my first songs I recorded. Now they're getting emailed to WCIC 91.5's radio station. I've started on some more songs. I'm recording so far. I've got 4 done so far on my second CD. My band's called The Light of Seraphim, Seraphim's an Angel. My first songs will be put on my site, so you can download them. Hopefully, it'll be done this week as well. I've written novels. I'm working with the publishers in Chicago. It'll take time. My songs and novels are for God, our Heavenly Father, and not for myself, so you understand me there. I sung some of my songs Tuesday at the Peoria's Courthouse. I'll vote every Tuesday between 11:30 a.m. and 12:30 p.m. as weather permits, and there's no events. I have their permission until October. I'm teaching on singing praise to God, our Heavenly Father, because you love Him and the love that comes from Him. My next calling from Him is to help truckers. I'm going to do a professional video and put it on YouTube when weather permits. The back to school bash, I haven't heard anything on it, so I'll keep you informed as I know things, if they have it or not. They've asked me to sing again if they do. October 6th is free day. October 6th is free day at the Peoria Zoo. I'm redoing last week's song, since you couldn't hear the music in the background, and I was having camcorder problem, so it's after my sermon. Excuse me, I got allergies bad. I also fixed up good use furniture for my organization. Okay, pray for California's wildfire and drought for the victims. Child's earthquake from a few weeks ago, Thursday. More than 1 million were evacuated and at least 8 were killed for the families and victims. Syrian refugees crisis for them. 2 weeks ago, Friday in Saudi Arabia, a towering construction crane that toppled and killed 107 during a major rainstorm for their families and victims. Washington State wildfire from a few weeks ago for the victims. The 3-year-old boy that drowned 2 months ago on the riverfront for his family. Excuse me. Earthquakes in Nepal from a few months ago for the victims. Dan, he has health problems. David, he has severe asthma. Margarita, she has health problems. John, Heather, and Donald, they are going through something personally. Donald's 2 older teenage daughters that are missing for their safety. Bob, his wife, passed away over a year ago from cancer. Our president, for his hard work and caring for our country, amen, amen, there. Rulers of our states and cities, schools, colleges, churches, pastors, teachers, bus drivers, parents, grandparents, cities, farmers, servicemen and women, firemen and women, policemen and women, I'm praying for you all. Pray for each other, for my organization, songs, novels, and house I'm living in. Amen, amen. Thank you. God bless you. Like I said, it's clouding up. It really looks like rain. And there's a lot of people around here. Someone tried to do my song. So ask yourself the second you get up, the second you go to bed. Who or what do you love, serve, and follow? Here's your God. Who or what? Who or what? Is where you're going to end. Is where you're going to end on His eternal judgment day. Between living eternally with God, our Heavenly Father, in His kingdom, or dying and suffering hell's fire at the end. Amen, amen. So remember that as you go through life here. Love, serve, and follow our Heavenly Father.
That's
exhale from faithful to Him. He's our real, true God, our Heavenly Father. He's the creator of life, and He provides life here for us. Amen, amen. And only by loving, serving, and following Him can we have eternal life with Him. Amen, amen. Thank you, and God bless you. Eternal home.